All right, so here's a summary of what we were just talking about. We have actually have these two different forms of the Bellman equation. One V, which we can think of as standing for value, and one Q, which we can think of as standing for quality, but mostly they're just letters from the end of the alphabet that we made up names for. So you had U for utility, this is V for value, and Q for quality. But anyway, the point is that these are just expressions that represent different pieces of this overall sequence of states and rewards and actions.
Okay, so I got two questions. One is, why? I mean, why are we bothering to create this quality function when the value function worked just fine? Thank you very much. And my second question, well, I'll ask the second question after you give me a satisfactory answer to the first one.
So why? So, you know, in some sense, because they're both equally good, but in fact, what's going to turn out to be the case is that this Q form of the Bellman equation is going to be much more useful in the context of reinforcement learning. And the reason for that is we're going to be able to take expectations of this quantity using just experience data. And you don't need to actually have direct access to the reward function or the transition function to do that. Whereas if we're going to try to learn V values, the only way to connect one V value to the next V value is by knowing the transitions and rewards. So this is going to be really helpful in the context of reinforcement learning where we don't know the transitions and rewards in advance.
Okay, I'll buy that. So here's my second question then. You've got V function for what happens when you're at a state. You've got a Q function, what happens when you're at an action. There's at least one more thing in that infinite sar, and that's R.
Yes. You're saying we can group things this way, or we can group things this way. So why can't we group things this way?
Sure. That's what I'm asking.
Because if we go one step more than that, then we're back to the max again, and that was our V.
Right.
So yeah, that seems to be the third member of our little trio that's been left out. So I think maybe we should have a quiz about that.
Of course we should.